Hi guys, welcome back to the Flying Apron. Today I'm making some kukras, and if you want to know how I make it, then please keep on watching the video. First of all, I'll start with the most important ingredient which enhances the flavor of kukras, that is chutneys. Starting with the garlic chutney, add some garlic in the mixer grinder, some green chilies, salt, and red chili powder. The green chilies is a secret ingredient of mine which I added and no one knows. Grind it and here it is. The garlic chutney is ready. For the green chutney I'll be taking gathia, or you can also take peanuts. Then add sugar to it, grind it and keep it aside. Now in the same pot add some green chilies. Garlic, ginger, and coriander. And once you add coriander, surely don't forget to add salt and lemon to it. Otherwise, the color will start turning black. Grind it and add that mixture of gathia and sugar and mix it, and here your chutney is ready. For the imli chutney, I'll be taking half cup of dates and half cup of imli, dried imli. You can adjust the imli and dates as per your taste. Then add water till it's submerged and boil it. Boil it till it gets softened. And once the water is completely reduced, switch off the flame. Then add it in a mixer grinder and grind it, make a thick paste. And then sieve it. Now to this add asafoetida, red chili powder, just 1 teaspoon for the color. You can skip this, and add salt and some black salt and jaggery. Again, you can adjust the jaggery as per your taste. Mix it. Now for the dough, I'll be taking wheat flour. You can also take maida. Add 1.5 tablespoon of oil, some salt to taste, to check whether the oil you have put is enough. It will hold the shape you make it. If it holds, then your oil is enough for the flour. Now knead it with the help of water. The dough should be semi-soft, not too hard, not too soft. Now coat it with some oil and keep it aside for minimum 30 minutes. Now for the stuffing, here I have soaked 1 cup of moong dal for 3 to 4 hours and I'll drain out the water. In a pan, add some oil, green chilies, curry leaves and 1 cup of water. To this add asafoetida and turmeric powder. The water should be as equal as the moong dal because we have already soaked it. After adding yellow moong dal to it, add some salt to taste and give it a very light mix, otherwise it will start sticking to the bottom of your pan, and cover it in and on slow flame. Cook it for around 7 to 8 minutes. Once it is done, don't mix the mixture, just put some red chili powder and keep it aside till it cools down. Now we'll start making the gugras. For this, take one portion from the dough. Knead it well and make sure there are no lines. Now make a giant size of roti out of it. Now with the help of a measuring cup or any vessel, just cut equal portions from that roti. You can take any size you want. Now take one part of it, add some stuffing to it. The stuffing should be very cold, it should not be hot at all. Now we'll press this, press the edges of both the sides so that the air is removed, and now folding it, the technique is to stretch and put it inside. Stretch and put it inside. Stretch and put it inside. This is the whole way you're going to do. Now we'll be deep frying them. Deep fry on low to medium flame. Don't put the flame high, otherwise the color will be dark brown and the gugras will be very soft. If at all any gugra is not made properly, then it will definitely break out. Don't worry, you just take out that from the kadai, let the other gugras fry. Deep fry them until they are golden brown. And that's it. Now I'll be plating them. In the middle I've put some boiled potatoes, then on the top of it some onions, green chutney, imli and dates chutney, and garlic chutney. Garnish it with some coriander and masala peanuts. And that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching the video. For detailed recipe, do check the description box. And for more new recipes, stay tuned till next Monday.